Gone are the days of password leaks and brute force attacks to guess them. We are moving to the passkey era. Well, are we actually? Why should we ditch the good old password for some new passkey? Let's do a proper passkey versus password comparison. Plus, I'll show you the best password managers that have both. So let's start with the basics. A password is a secret sequence of characters. Nothing mind-blowing here. It verifies your identity and grants access to whatever it is you're trying to log into. A passkey also verifies your identity, but instead of typing in characters, it just asks you to do something simple, like scanning your fingerprint, your face, or just unlocking your device the way you normally do. Some people also use those little USB thingies that can plug into your computer. But how do passkeys work? Your device generates two mathematically linked keys, a private one that stays on your device and a public one for the website. For example, when you want to log into a website, it says, hey, prove it's truly this fella to your phone and sends a challenge, a random piece of data. Your phone then asks you to confirm your identity, and this unlocks the private key. Then your phone sends back a response confirming that you're legit. The public key verifies the signature, and if it matches, bam, you're in. But there's no actual secret information that gets sent over the internet or stored on the servers where hackers could grab it. Even if a hacker would get the public key, it's basically useless to them. It's like having half a puzzle piece. They can't use it to pretend to be you because they'd still need your private key. And that one never leaves your device. Plus, they'd need to get past your fingerprint or face unlock to use it anyway. This is exactly why passkeys are considered to be stronger against threats like phishing. They can't be guessed or reused. Plus, while the process sounds long and complicated, it all happens in a matter of seconds, way faster than what it would take to type in a password or copy-paste it from a password manager app. Yet passkeys don't come without drawbacks. Only a handful of websites and platforms support passkeys so far. What's more, your login is dependent on your device, making your life much harder if the device gets lost or damaged. However, having a passkey on a password manager solves this issue, as you can then sync and use passkeys across devices. If you use a specific token as a passkey, for example, a YubiKey, you've still got to carry it with you. Plus, passkeys can't be exported. For instance, if you create a passkey with Apple passwords, you can't transfer it to a password manager app. You'll need to manually log into each and every website and change your passkey app there. So overall, don't blindly rely on passkeys. It's best to always have a backup plan. And in this case, I recommend using the best of both worlds, a password manager that also supports passkeys. There are a lot of password manager options out there and more than a few good ones, but today I've narrowed it down to just three options. I won't overly expand on them, but these are the ones that I think strike the best balance between security and a wallet-friendly price. NordPass Password Manager is what I use myself currently. It's very easy to set up and use. I store not only passwords here, but also stuff like my credit card details and addresses, because I can then autofill everything I need with a click, as long as I have the browser extension enabled. NordPass can also generate strong passwords or check how good my old ones are. By returning to the passkeys versus passwords topic, I really like that it shows which of my accounts can be turned into a passkey. So NordPass is my best recommendation for beginners, and they have a family plan as well. It has a better price per one user. Yet the title for the best password manager for families usually goes to 1Password. You can create shared folders with it, and if you have a family account on something with a passkey, like a shared Amazon account, you can put that in a shared folder with a select family member. It is super convenient. On the features and ease of use account, 1Password is very similar to NordPass, with a simple UI and all the necessary tools from password generation to password health checking watchtower. The latter tells you which of your accounts support 1Password passkeys, and you can go to the websites to set them up. And 1Password is already beta testing the ability to unlock this password manager itself with a passkey, eliminating the need for a master password for your vault. It is super useful if you tend to forget this kind of stuff, or you want to set 1Password up for an older family member, say. Then there's Proton Pass. This password manager is the newest of the bunch, but it comes from a non-profit cybersecurity firm, and it is completely open source. This means that their whole source code is publicly available, so people pitch in to find vulnerabilities or suggest improvements. Yet Proton Pass didn't take long to introduce passkeys for all of their plans, and you can use them on any Proton Pass app, including the browser extension. The app itself is a bit more techy, but if you're familiar with other Proton apps or spend a lot of time online in general, it shouldn't be an issue. But I do think that this password manager is a better fit for tech-savvy users and not complete beginners. Now, the process of enabling and using passkeys is very similar across the three providers. As I've said before, NordPass and 1Password show you which of your accounts support passkeys, so you can just go to that website from there and set it up. For example, if you want a passkey on an Amazon account, choose the login and security page, click the edit button near the passkey section, and then press to add a passkey. To add a passkey, your password manager should suggest saving it. In other cases, like with NordPass, for example, it only took a second as it automatically asks me if I wanted a passkey. I said yes, of course, and that was pretty much it. So I hope I got passkeys explained properly to you. What are your own thoughts on them? Personally, I have quite a few accounts set up this way already, specifically with NordPass, and I am not looking to go back. If you want to grab one of my recommended password managers, don't forget to check the description for exclusive discounts. Otherwise, I hope to see you in another video. Cheers.